गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सब्जेक्ट साइंस 2, चैप्टर 2, लाइफ प्रोसेस इन लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म पार्ट 1। टुडेज पॉइंट्स टू बी कवर्ड बाय वाटर इज एसेंशियल न्यूट्रिएंट, सेल डिवीजन एंड एसेंशियल लाइफ प्रोसेस, क्रोमोसोम, टाइप्स ऑफ क्रोमोसोम, मेटासेंट्रिक, सब मेटासेंट्रिक, एक्रोसेंट्रिक एंड टेलोसेंट्रिक। Use your brain power. Many times we experience dryness in mouth. We sweat during summer and heavy exercise. Now here the picture, if you see, our body consists of water, and the reason behind it, there is about 65 to 70% water in our body. Each cell contains 70% water weight by weight. Blood plasma is a yellowish fluid which is present in blood, also contains 90% of water. Functioning of cells and thereby whole body disturbs even if there is a little loss of water from the body. Hence, water is an essential nutrient. Now, here you can see the picture of fiber foods. Along with above mentioned nutrients, fibers are also essential nutrients. We cannot digest fibers. However, they help in digestion of other substances and eject of undigested substances. We obtain fibers from leafy vegetables, fruits and cereals, which you can see in the picture. Cell division and essential life process. Cell division is one of very important properties of cell and living organism. Due to this property only, a new organism is formed from the existing one. A multicellular organism grows up and emaciated, means extremely thin, weak because of illness, lack of food, etc., can be restored in body. There are two types of cell division, that is mitosis and meiosis. Now, mitosis occurs in somatic cells and stem cells of the body. Meiosis occurs in germ cells, that is sperm and ovum. Structural organization of the cell is cell, tissue, organ, organ systems and organism. Each cell has nucleus. Besides, other cell organelles are also present. Before any type of cell division, the cells double up its chromosome number present in its nucleus, that is chromosome number is 2n and it doubles up to 4n. Now we'll see diploid 2n cell. With the help of diagram, we'll see here the chromosome number is double. So you can see here the chromosome number is double. Now the diploid 2n cell, the cell in which chromosome number is double, are known as diploid cell. Male and female gametes unite together in process of fertilization. The chromosome mix together in zygote, therefore the chromosome number is always diploid. Example, diploid chromosome number in human beings is 46, and we have 46 chromosome in each of our body cell. Now we'll see haploid N cell. Now with the help of diagram you'll see only one set of chromosome in each cell. Okay, so here haploid N cell, the cells with only one set of chromosome is called as haploid cell. At the time of sexual reproduction, there is meiosis. In meiosis, chromosome number of parental germ cells are reduced to half. Therefore, the gametes are haploid. The haploid chromosome number N in human beings is 23. Sperm and ovum both are haploid, carrying 23 chromosome each. Chromosome, we'll see figure first. Here we can see two identical chromatid here. It is called as P arm, short arm structure, then centromere, Q arm and DNA molecule. Now we'll see chromosome are seen only at a time of cell division. Chromosome are rod shape and has primary constriction or centromere. The arms, now these are the arms, are seen to be attached at centromere. Depending upon the position of centromere and the length of the chromosome, there are four types of chromosome. types of chromosome. First one is metacentric. Metacentric, it is V-shaped chromosome with central centromere, here you can see, and equal chromatids, means you can see equal chromatids arm. Submetacentric, here you will see it is L-shaped with centromere somewhere near the midpoint in the chromosome. Its one arm is slightly shorter than other. You will see this arm is shorter than other. Acrocentric. It is a J shape. So, chromosome with centromere near the end of the chromosome. Telocentric. The centromere is at the right at the end of the chromosome, resulting into only one arm and thus look like I shape. So it look like a I shape like this. Let's have a quick recap. Many times we experience dryness in mouth. We sweat during summer and in heavy exercise. Reason behind it, there is about 65-70% water in our body. Each cell contains 70% water weight by weight. Blood plasma also contains 90% of water. Functioning of cells, thereby whole body disturbs even if there is a little loss of water from the body. Hence, water is essential nutrient. Along with all above mentioned nutrients, fiber are also essential nutrients. We cannot digest fiber. However, they help in digestion of other substance and nutrition of undigested substance. We obtain fibers from leafy vegetables, fruit and cereals. Cell division, an essential life process. Cell division is one of the very important property of cell and living organism. Due to this property only, the new organism is formed from existing one and a multicellular organism grow up. Emaciated means extremely thin and weak because of illness, lack of food, etc. can be restored in body. There are two types of cell division. Again, we'll see mitosis and meiosis. Mitosis occurs in somatic and stem cells. Meiosis occurs in germ cells. Structural organization of cell is cell, tissue, organ, organ system and organism. Each cell has nucleus. Besides, other cell organelles are also present. Before any type of cell division, cells double up its chromosome number present in its nucleus. That is, chromosome number is 2N, it is doubled up to 4N. Diploid 2N cell and haploid N cell. Now, diploid 2N cell means the cells in which chromosome number is double are known as diploid cells. Male and female gametes unite together in the process of fertilization. Chromosome mix together in zygote, therefore the chromosome number is always diploid. Example, diploid chromosome numbers in human beings is 46. We have 46 chromosome in each of our body cells. Haploid N cell. The cells with only one set of chromosome is known as haploid cell. At the time of sexual reproduction, there is meiosis. In meiosis, chromosome number of a parental germ cells are reduced to half. Therefore, gametes are haploid. Haploid chromosome number N in human beings is 23. Sperm, ovum, both are haploid carrying 23 chromosome. Chromosome, we'll see the figure first. Here, two identical chromatid, P arm, then centromere here, Q arm and DNA molecule here. Then, we'll see chromosome are seen only at the time of cell division. Chromosome are rod shape and has primary constriction or centromere. The arms of chromosome seem to be attached at centromere. Depending upon the position of centromere and the length of the chromosome, there are four types of chromosome. Let's study the first type of chromosome. metacentric. Now, metacentric chromosome is a V shape with a central centromere and equal chromatin arms. The next is submetacentric. It is L shape and with a centromere near the midpoint in the chromosome. Its one arm is slightly shorter than the other. The next one is acrocentric. Here, it J-shaped chromosome with a centromere near the end of the chromosome. And the last one is telocentric. The centromere is right at the end of the chromosome here and resulting only in one arm, and thus it look like a I shape.